Hey, yo, good evening, viewers of the Tube. My name is Tyler of Chico Crypto, and welcome to the channel that keeps the information flowing and then clogs the scammers to stop them dead set in their tracks. It's time for Chico Crypto. Today, we are going to talk about the state of the markets and what I personally think is going to happen in the short term, midterm, and the long term for the price of Bitcoin, which is the overall driver of the price of every other altcoin. If Bitcoin goes up, then the rest of the crypto markets go up. If Bitcoin goes down, then the rest of the crypto markets go down. That is a fact, and I do not see that changing anytime soon. As you can see, I haven't cut my hair, and I said I won't cut it until the bear market is officially over. But it may possibly be over as the overall market sentiment is turning more bullish. Although, since I do have a character on the show, Chip Chodler, who has long, slick back hair, that was a sarcastic chip off the old block joke, if you couldn't tell. I might have to keep these luscious locks. That brings me into my first point for the show, my short-term outlook for Bitcoin. Like Rumpelstiltskin said in the evening news with Chip, yes, the 4K USD price has massive resistance, and the price has touched it a few times. But every time it moves slightly past it, someone places large amounts of market sells throughout the order book. Although, all those sells get quickly eaten alive and the price is pushed right back up. There is some intense buy pressure, and the volume of trading that is occurring in the past 4 days with Bitcoin is greater than when Bitcoin was near $12,000 in January of 2018. If we push through 4K, the volume is going to explode, and I wouldn't doubt that it exceeds the volume when Bitcoin was at its peak of nearly 20K. The theory I've come to the conclusion is we may have some very large bearish whales who have been making a killing since the dip down from 20K. These bearish whales need the price to stay under 4K, and the bearish trend to continue down into the 2K level, or else they are going to get their shorts liquidated and lose some big stacks. They are doing everything in their power right now, putting in mass market sell orders to keep the price under 4K. Although, there are some bullish smaller to medium-sized whales who outnumber the bearish whales, and they just gobble up all the sells. This is a battle right now, and if the bulls win and we push through 4K, these bulls are not going to sell, and those larger bearish whales will give up massive positions, resulting in them buying in at a much higher price, which could trigger something we like to call FOMO. This leads us into my personal opinion on the medium-term outlook for Bitcoin. Looking at the charts pre-2017 bull run and through today, the chart looks pretty damn ugly. You don't have to be an expert to see that, yes, indeed, the market went into a bubble phase, followed by an intense but much needed collapse back down. Although, if we compare this to the market cycle cheat sheet, the chart looks eerily similar to exactly what we have all went through, all the emotions, and we may very well be going through the disbelief stage. No way in hell Bitcoin could be going up right now. This is a sucker's rally. It surely will come back down past 3.2K and into the 2K level. Well, I am no fortune teller, but I like to look at the reality of what is going on with Bitcoin. Overall, the transactions for Bitcoin are increasing. The fees for Bitcoin transactions are falling, and hash rate is on the rise. This data chart posted on the Bitcoin subreddit sums up the realities nicely. Last week, the average Bitcoin network fee fell to its lowest of 18 cents, the lowest price for a Bitcoin transaction in nearly 2 years. Also, the volume of sent Bitcoins through transactions, which pretty much means Bitcoins changing hands, has gone up by 3x. And the number of transactions is increasing day by day, month by month, since its low in April of 2018. These are all good signs that lead me to believe we are in the disbelief stage and Bitcoin may have hit its bottom of 3,200 in December of last year. So what does this mean? Another parabolic bull run incoming? Nope, not anytime soon. If the bear market has ended, it stretched on for nearly as long as the bear market after the 2013 parabolic bull run. Over 400 days. These runs and subsequent crashes are very similar. So I'd expect the resulting bull markets to be similar as well. As we can see from this chart, it took nearly 2 years for Bitcoin to smash up towards its old all-time high from the lowest point in January of 2015. I would expect the same thing this time around. Maybe shorter, maybe a bit longer, but if the 3200 low in mid-December of this year was the low this time around, we will have to wait until December of 2020 until Bitcoin breaks back through the 20K mark. This seems like a long time, but let me tell you, since I have been around the market since 2013, that time goes extremely quick. Patience is a virtue, my friends, and the Chico Army has all the time in the world. Now, this leads us into my personal long-term outlook for Bitcoin. These market cycles of intense parabolic bull runs, extended bear markets, and the like will continue, and I expect this to happen for another 10 years or so. Why? Because our world is currently in the beginning stages of an economic paradigm shift. World debt is at an all-time high. Countries' governments are borrowing and borrowing and borrowing with no regard that this can't go on forever. Negative interest rates are being floated by the International Monetary Fund. Governments are being forced to engage in balance sheet reductions. And here in the US, interest rate growth is being halted. Economies across the globe are going insane, like the stock market here in the US. But there are major signs that it is going to collapse. This means long-term good things for Bitcoin, as people will move away from traditional financial institutions and instruments that have continually failed them, leading to decreased purchasing power of fiat. Could this mean $1 million Bitcoin in the future? I have always said yes, this will eventually happen. And Jesse Lund, VP of Blockchain and Digital Currencies at IBM, agrees. Let's listen in.
Is dependent upon the price of the asset, because a higher price actually creates more liquidity, and more liquidity raises the value of the utility of the network itself. And so I would just try to get people to think more, not in terms of value of the coin, whatever their favorite coin is, but think about the utility of that coin in a network. If Bitcoin, which is everyone's, you know, favorite to talk about and to beat up on, but if the price of Bitcoin were higher, there would be more liquidity in the network, we could be having a really different discussion with banks right now. But, you know, we're speculating, and speculators are a necessary part of the market, but I think they're hurting the value, and I think it's because we're thinking about it wrong, if that makes sense.
We ask everyone on the show, Jesse, to make a prediction for New Year's Eve 2019, the price of Bitcoin in US dollars. I was wondering if you could share with us, this is not financial advice, by the way, guys, but just your opinion, what that might be.
Yeah, thanks for the disclaimer. Right?
Disclaimer, always have a disclaimer.
So I think it's going to be higher. I'll go with 5,000, but let me just say this. I have a long-term outlook, and I've actually, you know, blogged about this a little bit. It goes back to that discussion about the utility of the network with a higher price. So I see Bitcoin at $1 million someday, and I like that number because, you know, if Bitcoin's at $1 million, then Satoshi is on value parity with the US penny, right? And that means there's over $20 trillion of liquidity in this network, right? Think about $20 trillion of liquidity and how that changes things like corporate payments, right? Large value payments, and what that does to the global landscape, if that financial services landscape, if that happens. So I see maybe 5,000 at the end of the year. It's going up, but I see a way higher upward trajectory.
I like Jesse's prediction and agree with his midterm and long term. But then there is John McAfee, who just put out a prediction. $1 million Bitcoin by 2020. Who to believe? I'm going with Jesse. Cheers, viewers. I'll see you next time.